on the bus again into London today to see Tom Gresford, Architects, and also have a new toy, which is a sound recorder. We're going to try and use it today. So I'm now recording on the sound recorder, which hopefully should sound a bit better, and also means I don't have to shout because we're on a crowded bus. We're going to see Tom Gresford to basically talk about our self-build project, and we don't have a plot yet, we don't have a budget yet, but we're going to talk to him anyway just to get the ball rolling. We've got some information from Graven Hill to take to him, and we think we've still got a month and a half until Graven Hill plots are actually released, and we're just trying to get as far advanced as we reasonably can with what we have, which is some plot details, plot passport for one plot, and the map of the phase one plots. So it's enough to sort of get us going, I think. And we also had a bit of information today from Build Store about a possible mortgage, so we're sort of slowly piecing things together. So sort of a bit nervous, a bit excited about today really, because it's probably the first proper step towards what is hopefully going to be our self-built project. But it could also be the meeting where we realise that our budget is nowhere near enough and we can't do anything like what we're hoping, but we'll see how it goes. So Hannah's also with me, she's on the camera. That's proof. We'll hopefully be able to take some footage of us getting lost in the middle of London and then arriving at Tom's studio. So we'll see you in a bit. So we arrived at the train station. And I'm just walking around the corner now to Tom Gresford's, so hopefully he's there. Yeah, hi, it's Dean and Hannah here to see Tom. We've already made our first wrong turn. Too high. We're out onto the balcony. I think we're in the right place. Just went to Gresford's, just met Tom. Getting a cup of tea and a glass of water. And, we start talking about our project. So it's quite a funky little office, this. I don't want to put people on camera just in case they don't want to be filmed, but hi Tom. just saying, here's Tom.
Do you want a hot chocolate as opposed to tea? That's an important moment for your vlog.
I'll go stick with the tea.
I'll go for hot chocolate.
Okay.
Yes.
Can we get one more hot chocolate?
Yeah.
Back in the seat.
Thank you. Why not? So, if you like, we can just go through what we've got.
Yeah, no, tell me. I mean, I really, and so I guess what you mentioned in your emails was basically having to get a kind of design together to submit to them.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
they don't expect you to have a very detailed design, but a design and a budget.
Right. So this is the thing. The list they've given to us. So these points here. So an initial rough plan, the sort of house that you want to build, a rough budget. So they do want to see a breakdown of what that budget is, so they can make a judgment about whether you're realistic or not. The construction method. Whether you are going to be self-building or it's going to be a turnkey style solution. Your three favourite plots.
Which is an interesting
one. Which is an interesting one. And how are you actually going to, some evidence that you can actually finance. So on these issues, obviously, the things that we can sort of control initially is the finance and, to some extent, the budget.
So finished our meeting with Tom, and just waiting for the train home. We'll head into central London, find somewhere to have dinner, have a bit of a debrief, discuss what was actually quite an exciting couple of hours, actually, talking about the plans. There's definitely plenty for us to think about, especially on the budget and the finances, which is probably going to be the trickiest part of it, really. But we've got a bit more information from Build Store, so yeah, I just need to get back to the spreadsheets, obviously the most exciting part of the self-build, and see where we are. So I think the train's going to be quite busy, judging by the number of people on that one. We'll have a debrief and let you know how we get on. It's a bit noisy in here. We're at Victoria train station trying to decide what we're going to have for dinner. Not that many options so far. That's not really good for a meal. And we got Costa, that's no good. How do you feel about Mexican?
Mexican.
Good work. Different. I think all the food's upstairs at least, so let's go upstairs. So we've gone for the Fresh Pizza Company. They have an all-you-can-eat pizza buffet for £7.50. You can't argue that. Anna's got her buffet. What have you got, Anna?
Ham and pineapple.
Ham and pineapple.
Veggie pizza.
We have some salads going on here.
Salads. Beetroots. Dressing and
potato
chips.
Good effort. Okay, so I've gone for a slightly spicier smelling pizza. It's got some peppers on it, so it should be a bit spicy. Ham and pineapple and chicken thing. And I've gone for some salad so I don't feel too bad about having the pizza. Especially because we'll probably be having pizza for dinner tomorrow night as well. Okay, so we've settled down for a bit of dinner at the Fresh Pizza Company and had a pizza buffet, two plates each, and some salad, so
balance it out a
balance
bit.
Balance it out. Just wanted to have a debrief. Following our meeting with Tom, while it's still fresh in our minds. And it's just easier to do this with sound rather than holding the camera up as well at the same time. It's a little bit noisy in here, but hopefully you can pick us out okay. So we're in there for 2 hours.
Yep.
So it was a pretty long meeting, but I mean, it went really quickly. I think we just had loads to say, loads to show Tom. Graven Hill. And so we had all the maps and everything out, and talking about some of our ideas, went through some of our design brief, and I think it all, I mean, basically we seem to be very much on the same page.
Yep.
And I suppose for him it was probably a bit like preaching to the choir, really. We're definitely sort of on board with the whole passive house stuff, which he clearly is as well. And I think we sort of share a similar sort of taste in terms of sort of quite modern, contemporary style, which is quite clean.
Yeah, and you seem to understand the types of things that we like. I think he's quite pleased that we'd got quite a lot of images and captured lots of pictures of things that we've seen that we've liked, to give them a feel of what our taste is.
Yeah. So I think it was pretty clear from the meeting that in terms of sort of delivering what we would want and the constraints of Graven Hill, which aren't really that great in terms of a design point of view, that's all totally feasible.
Yep.
It's really just going to be down to what sort of budget we can pull together.
Mm-hmm.
It's obviously something that all self-builders struggle with. You want to try and get away with building an expensive house but on a small budget.
Yep.
And obviously it doesn't work out like that. You have to live within your means.
Yep.
And so we've got to go away now really and try and go into a bit more detail on the budget. We think, based on sort of the back of a fag packet calculations, that we would probably need to be somewhere in the region of £400,000 as a total budget.
Yep. All in for everything.
We're making some tricky assumptions here about what the actual plot price will be, because we don't know that. We've only got indicative prices from Graven Hill, and we don't know whether some plots, like the slightly bigger plots, will be even more money than that, and they may well be.
Yep.
We just don't know. But based on the information that they've given us so far, we think something around 400,000 would be something that would give us quite a luxurious house, basically. And obviously less than that, we start to reduce what we can have in terms of the quality, but most importantly, probably floor space is what you have to sacrifice.
Yeah.
Beyond that, I mean, we were saying you could talk to Tom for hours and hours.
Yep.
He's quite enthusiastic and he's easy to talk to, and he definitely listened to what we had to say.
So Hannah, what
were your feelings about the meeting, how it went?
I came away feeling quite positive about the meeting, and the fact that there's definitely no issues with Tom potentially being our architect in terms of kind of the personal relationship of being able to talk to him and discuss what we like. And I'm fairly confident that he understands where we're coming from and the ideas that we have. And I suppose the budget side of it isn't unexpected, but it's still kind of, it's not an easy thing to accept that perhaps to have kind of the upper end of the size range of the plot, we'd need to increase that budget than kind of our initial estimation. We've got some interesting things to think about in terms of how we might actually be able to achieve that. But there's the possibility of kind of balancing the costs in terms of spending more on the structure and the building, and then perhaps reducing the internal spec of the nice things in the house, and then developing those later on when we have more money available. So it's not a complete...
Thank you
very much. So it's not a complete showstopper for the plans that we've got.
Yeah. I mean, this house is definitely a long-term project, as far as these things go. We're not sort of planning to build it and then move on in a few years. So if we had to compromise on the spec of things like kitchen and furniture initially, then I think that's something we'd be happy to do if it meant that we got more space, knowing that we can improve things in later years. But yeah, overall, it was an enjoyable couple of hours, and maybe it's a bit of a nice fantasy to sort of think, oh wow, we can have all this nice stuff, and maybe once we've had a look at the numbers, we'll come back down to earth, but we'll see how we get on. I think what Tom was talking about in terms of passive house all made sense. We were saying afterwards as well that you can speak to 10 different people about sort of the eco qualities of a house and get 10 different opinions, and you get pushed and pulled in all sorts of directions, but at the end of the day, it's our project and our house, and we have to go with what we feel is right and what we want.
We have to weigh it all up and make our own judgment.
Yeah, whether we think that's financially the right thing to do is up to us. And, we've got some thinking to do about that. In terms of timescales, it's a problem, which is specific to Graven Hill, is that they're not potentially giving you much time to go away and think about it. But, you know, that's... I can see from their point of view that they want to get the process going as soon as possible.
Yeah.
And it's a commercial operation, so, you know, first come, first serve works for them. We'll see. We've got a lot of work to do, but I think we're kind of, so far, we seem to be piecing things together, and it just remains to be seen whether it will
go. I suppose I feel fairly confident that we'll be able to pull together all the different answers to the five or so questions that are going to form the application for the plot at Graven Hill, and that's kind of about as good as I think we could be at this point.
And the other thing with the service that we'd get from Tom is it would be pretty much a complete package in terms of the design, the specification of the passive house elements, structural engineering, quantity surveying, project management. If we're able to do it from a budget point of view, then it would be quite a straightforward approach, I think, which would be nice.
Mm-hmm.
But for now, I think we're doing what we can, we're doing the right things, and we're going from here. So we finished our pizzas.
Yep.
Which is pretty good. £7.50.
Mm-hmm.
And go and get the tube home. That's the Oxford tube, not the London tube.
Yep.
And
hope the traffic's not too bad.
Yeah, hope Lucas isn't too grumpy with us for not feeding him until late.
Yeah, he probably will be grumpy.
Yeah, we've got a weekend free to think about things a little bit more.